Welcome to Dental and Ayurveda, a channel for basic dental and basic Ayurvedic sciences. Our today's topic is hypersensitivity of microbiology.
So in this video, we are going to talk about hypersensitivity. And so what is hypersensitivity? It is a condition in which immune response results in excessive reactions, which is going to lead to tissue damage or even death can occur. So what is the classification of hypersensitivity? So it is the two main types are immediate and delayed types. So according to Combs and Gels classification, hypersensitivity, it is of four major types. One is anaphylactic, then the second type is cytotoxic, third type is immune complex, and type 4 is delayed or cell mediated. Then all these three types, they are going to depend upon the interaction antigen with humoral antibodies, and this is known as the immediate type reactions. And then we are going to talk about the type 4 reaction. So this is basically mediated by T lymphocytes. So let's start with the type 1, that is anaphylactic reaction. So in this type 1 reactions, they occur in two forms. One is the acute potentially fatal form, systemic form called anaphylaxis, and the recurrent non-fatal localized form known as atopy. So the mechanism of anaphylaxis is basically on your screen. So this is anaphylaxis occurs when a sensitized individual is going to come in contact with a shocking dose of antigen. So here starts with the mechanism of anaphylaxis. Then there is sensitization that may occur by any route, such as it can be parenteral or ingestion or inhalation, but the most effective route that by which this occurs is the parenteral route. And an interval of 2 to 3 weeks is required between the sensitizing and the shocking dose. So 2 to 3 weeks are required, during which the cytotropic antibody IgE produced against the antigen, it is going to attach to the surface receptors of mast cells and basophils. So when a shocking dose of same or immunologically related antigen is given, the antigen is going to combine with cell-bound IgE antibody on the mast cells. Then second are the chemical mediators. So chemical mediators are of two types: primary mediators, which are performed contents of mast cell and basophil granules, and the second is your secondary mediators, which are newly formed upon the stimulation of mast cells, basophils, and other leukocytes. Then primary mediators, under primary mediators, you can see first is histamine. So this is like the most important if I am talking about human anaphylaxis. And it also causes vasodilation, which you may have read about, and increased capillary permeability also, and contraction of smooth muscles. Then we talk about serotonin. So it is going to cause vasoconstriction, it increases the capillary permeability and smooth muscle contraction. Then eosinophil, chemotactic factor of anaphylaxis. So this is going to contribute to the eosinophilia, which is associated with many hypersensitivity. Then we are going to talk about the secondary mediators. So these secondary mediators, they're slow reacting substances of anaphylaxis. So it is more potent bronchoconstrictor than histamine, and it can also cause sustained contraction of the smooth muscles. Then under secondary mediators, we have prostaglandins and thromboxane. So prostaglandins and thromboxane, they are bronchoconstrictors again. Then platelet activating factor, it causes aggregation of platelets and release their vasoactive amines. So it is going to release the vasoactive amines. Then other mediators of anaphylaxis, they are going to include the bradykinin and obviously other kinins also from the plasma. Then we have features of anaphylaxis. Anaphylaxis occurs with a few seconds to few minutes following the shocking dose of antigen. Cytotropic IgE antibody is responsible for this. Then tissues or organs which are affected in anaphylaxis, these are known as target tissues or shock organs. Lung is the principal shock organ in humans. Then bronchospasm, laryngeal edema, or respiratory distress, even death may occur in this case. Then we have some types of anaphylaxis. So the first type of anaphylaxis in vitro. So it may be induced when a small shocking dose of antigen is there given by any intradermal route or to a sensitized host. Then cutaneous anaphylaxis is useful in testing hypersensitivity and in identifying the allergen which is responsible in atopy. Then we have that is atopy. So basically it is typified by hay fever and asthma. So the antigens commonly involved in atopy are pollens, house dust and foods. Then we have, you can see these atopants, they are going to induce IgE antibodies, the termed as regain antibodies also. We call it as regain antibodies. So what are the features of atopy? So atopy runs in families. So these individuals have tendency to produce regain antibody in large amounts. Now you can see reactions, they occur at the site of entry of the antigen, where from where the antigen enters. Phir inhalation hota hai pollens ka, toh that is going to affect the lungs. Then ingestion of any, you know, fish, milk, eggs or drugs also. Then you can see that it is IgE mediated hypersensitivity reaction, and IgE is homocytotropic, that is species specific hota hai. Then you can see the mechanism of atopy. What is the mechanism under this? So atopin jo hote hain, these are going to combine with the cell bound IgE antibodies which are, you know, present on the surface of mast cells and the basophils, and this antigen antibody ka jo complex banta, this is going to stimulate these cells to release the release the mediators resulting in clinical features of atopy. So you can see some examples like food allergy, that is, it may occur. Many people, they suffer from allergy from egg or from mushroom. Now then dust allergy is also there. And then example from pollens or house dust. Then drug allergy like from penicillin, and in from many medicines people face allergies. Then this PK reaction. So this, in this reaction you can see the original method for detecting atopic antibody. This is the another reaction. Now this is reported that if serum collected from Kirshner who had a gastrointestinal allergy to certain cooked fish, he was having some from the cooked fish that was injected intracutaneous into frost nets, which is like followed 24 hours later by injecting the small amount of cooked fish extract into the same site. Now a wheal and a flare reaction, it occurred at the site of injection with minutes. Then the special affinity of IgE for skin cells forms the base of PK reaction. So this test is not done. We do not do this test nowadays due to the risk of transmission of serum hepatitis. So due to this, we are not now. Then type 2 cytotoxic reaction. So in this reaction, it is mediated by IgG directed against the antigens which are causing any cell damage. Then antibodies, these are going to bind to antigen on the surface, and then phagocytosis occurs. This cytotoxicity and lysis through activation of complement system. So all this is going to happen. Example of any cytotoxic reaction, it can be autoimmune anemia. Then drug reactions like Pseudomonas purpura. And type 3 is immune complex reaction. So it is basically the deposition of antigen antibody complexes in tissues mein ye jo complex banta hai, this is going to deposit in the tissues. then activation of complement and infiltration of polymorphonuclear leukocytes. This is going to cause the tissue damage. Then we have types of reactions under this. First is the Arthur's reaction. So in this Arthur's reaction, antigen-antibody complex are deposited on the walls of blood vessels. Blood vessels ke walls pe deposition hota hai is complex ka. This complex activate the complement and it is going to attract the neutrophils. Then leukocyte platelet thrombi are these. This is formed, which is going to cause the tissue necrosis. Then we talk about the serum sickness. So serum sickness, it appears following a single injection of high concentration of foreign serum. Then antibodies to this foreign serum, this reach by 7 to 12 days, and but some of them still remain. Then serum sickness is different from other reactions. Why? Because in that, a single dose serve as both sensitizing and shocking dose. So serum sickness baki reaction se different hai, kyunki isme sensitizing and shocking dose dono hi matlab dono purpose ho rahe hai isme in a single dose. Then we have type 4, that is delayed or cell mediated reaction. So mediated by sensitized T lymphocytes which on contact with the antigen. So jaise hi antigen ke contact mein aayenge, these are going to release lymphocytes. And this reaction, delayed one, it occurs in 42 to 72 hours. Now it cannot be transferred by serum as it is not antibody mediated. So first in delayed type we have tuberculin. So when a small dose of tuberculin, it is injected intradermally in a person which is already sensitized by tuberculoprotein by prior infection. So a swelling occur at that site of infection. Then tuberculin test is indicator of cell mediated immunity. Now you can see that various skin tests we do for this, the leptonin test, we consider this test as positive in tuberculosis leprosy, but we consider it negative in lepromatous type of leprosy. So these are the tests. Now contact dermatitis. So second one, we talk about contact dermatitis. So sometimes, you know, skin contact with a range of like sensitizing materials like nickel or any drugs like, you know, penicillin or ointments. So ye jitte bhi hai, simple chemicals bhi hote hai hamare in soap, can also lead to delayed hypersensitivity. Then we have the type 5, that is stimulatory type reaction. So it is the modification of, so this type 5 is actually the modification of type 2 hypersensitivity. Antibodies interact with the antigens on cell surface, that is going to lead to cell proliferation. So isme cell proliferation and differentiation hoga instead of inhibition or killing. Jaise type 2 hypersensitivity mein inhibition hota tha, killing ho jati thi. In this type 5, it is the modification of type 2. In this, there is cell proliferation and differentiation. Then example can be Graves' disease, in which Graves' disease, that is excess thyroid hormone is released in this disease. So this was all about the two types of delay.
Thank you for watching. Do like, share and subscribe. And this chapter ke ready to read notes available hai hamare Instagram page pe, jiska link given hai description box mein.